Some of you might have experienced that when you apply a force on the spinning wheel to change its direction of rotation, it doesn't move in the direction that we want. Or when we connect a spinning wheel to a string like this, the wheel would start to rotate around the string. This very strange and non-intuitive behavior of rotating objects is caused by the effect called the gyroscopic effect. Gyroscopic effect is nothing but a result of the angular momentum conservation principle. Before going into what angular momentum is, let's first explore the linear momentum. Linear momentum is the product of an object's mass and its velocity. For example, a truck moving with very low velocity and a bullet fired from a gun might have the same linear momentum because the truck is heavy and the bullet is fast. Now, the linear momentum only deals with the linear motion, that is the motion in a straight line, but when there is a rotational motion, the angular momentum kicks in. The angular momentum is the product of moment of inertia I and angular velocity omega. The moment of inertia is equal to mass multiplied by r squared, but it depends upon the shape and axis of rotation of the object, and we will not go deep into that because that's a topic for another video. But for simplicity, let's assume that moment of inertia equal to m multiplied by r squared. Now putting I equal to mr squared gives us L equals mr squared into omega. So this is our equation of angular momentum. Now there is another very important term which we should discuss, that is the torque. Torque is equal to r into f, where r is the radius at which force is applied and f is the amount of force applied perpendicular to the radius. In the next part, we will discuss how to determine the direction of torque and angular momentum. Torque and angular momentum both are vector quantities. It means that they have direction and magnitude both. The direction of angular momentum is determined by your right hand. So when you take your right hand and curl your fingers in the direction of rotation, your thumb will give the direction of angular momentum. Now the direction of torque is actually perpendicular to both r and f vectors, and it is determined by the right hand rule, in which you take your right hand and place your fingers in the direction of radius and swirl it in the direction of force, and your thumb will give the direction of torque vector. Alright, this is enough information required for you to understand the gyroscopic effect, so let's get started. Now let's understand the gyroscopic effect with the help of a bicycle wheel. Suppose you want to rotate this bicycle wheel. You will apply a force perpendicular to the radius. This means that you are applying a torque. Now the direction of torque vector is going inside the screen, which is determined by the right hand rule that we have discussed. So, by looking at the wheel from right hand side, it looks like this. And as soon as we apply the force, the wheel starts to rotate, which will generate the angular momentum in the direction going inside the screen. Now that the wheel is spinning, we will not be giving any force by our hand, and therefore the torque acting on the wheel is now zero. But if the person holding the wheel applies the force to change the axis of rotation of wheel like this, then the torque applied by both of these forces will be in the direction perpendicular to the axis of rotation of the wheel, which is shown over here. Before going further, let's go past in time and go to our school where we have learned this equation F equals delta P by delta T. What this equation tells us is that the rate of change of momentum is equal to the resultant force applied and is in the direction of resultant force. What it means in simple words is that when you apply a force to an object, like when we push this ball in the positive x direction, its momentum will change in the positive x direction. That is, its velocity will increase in this direction. And when we apply the force in the opposite direction, that is the negative x direction, it means that the velocity of ball will increase in the negative x direction and the ball will slowly reach into a rest position. Now this fact proves that the direction of change in the momentum is in the direction of applied force. Alright, knowing this, let's come back to our bicycle wheel. Now comes the very important and very non-intuitive part of this video. So I urge you to pay your utmost attention for 30 seconds. So we were discussing what will happen to the wheel if we apply a force with our hands to kind of change the axis of rotation of wheel like this. Our intuition is that the wheel must move like this, right? What else could happen? Let's find out. As we have seen that the force applied will change the linear momentum of an object in the direction of force, the same rule applies to the torque and angular momentum. Here, our wheel has an angular momentum in this direction, and we have applied the torque to the wheel in the direction perpendicular to it. Let's say this torque will change the angular momentum to delta L amount in the direction of torque. So, our new angular momentum vector will try to change in the direction that is the summation of L and delta L vectors. So the new angular momentum vector will point to this direction. And as we know that the angular momentum is always perpendicular to the plane of rotation, the whole wheel will rotate in this direction. Pretty strange, isn't it?
We have applied a force to change the axis of rotation of the wheel in this plane, but it actually changes in this plane. Now this very strange phenomenon is known as the gyroscopic effect.
It will be more clear if we understand with another example. Let's say we connect a wheel to a string with a hook, and the string is fixed at one end, and suppose we let go the wheel from this condition when it is not rotating, the wheel would fall off due to gravity, right? But something strange happens when we rotate the wheel and then attach it with the string. Let's try to find out with our knowledge of gyroscopic effect. If the wheel is rotating anticlockwise, its angular momentum is in the direction coming out of the screen. Now if we let go the rotating wheel, then the gravity would try to push it down. So this force would generate a torque in the R cross F direction, which is this direction, and now the angular momentum vector would try to change in the direction of torque like this, and the new angular momentum will be in the direction of summation of L and delta L vectors. And after it changes direction, the plane of rotation of wheel also move in order to remain the perpendicular to the angular momentum vector. And as soon as the wheel rotates about this string, the torque acting due to gravity would also change in the direction so that it is perpendicular to the R and F vectors. And this process continues and the wheel starts to rotate about the string until its angular momentum decreases due to friction. And this is called the gyroscopic effect. As we know that the gyroscopic effect applies when there is any change in the angular momentum of a rotating object. You might wonder that airplanes and ships are not rotating objects. Then how come the gyroscopic effect applies here? Well, they certainly do not rotate, but they have massive rotating objects inside it. For example, airplanes have two or more jet engines in which there are many layers of turbines and compressor blades rotating with very high RPM, and this will generate a large amount of angular momentum. And ships also have massive propellers which will generate a large amount of angular momentum. Now I will only discuss the gyroscopic effect in airplanes, and the same will also apply for the ships. Now let's assume that rotors inside the engine of an airplane are rotating in clockwise direction as seen from behind. This will generate the angular momentum in forward direction. Now when the plane takes left turn, these angular momentum vectors are forced to rotate in this direction. But there is not any external torque present which will change these angular momentum vectors. And without any external torque, the angular momentum vectors cannot change because of the angular momentum conservation principle. Now in this situation, what airplane does is that it tells the pilot that, hey, Mr. Pilot, you want to change my direction of angular momentum in left, then you have to apply a torque to me in the left direction. But the pilot tells the plane that no, we are not in a condition to give you torque in this direction, you have to adjust yourself. Now plane thinks that, okay, you are not giving me torque but want to change my angular momentum in left direction. Then I will assume that you have given me the torque in the left direction, and I will also give myself the same amount of torque in the right direction so that the net effect of both torque vectors cancels out and everybody reaches their home happily. So what happens is that the torque in the left direction is utilized into changing the angular momentum in left direction, but the torque in right direction is not utilized into anything. So this torque acts to airplane, and what this torque does is that it will lift the nose of the airplane up and lower the tail. Now when the plane takes right turn, it will generate the torque in left direction and it will lower the nose and lift the tail. And now you can figure this out by yourself. This is how the gyroscopic effect applies to airplane, and the same is also true for ships. I hope you understood the gyroscopic effect. And if you have any doubts, you can put them in the comment box below and I'll be happy to answer them. If you like this video, then press the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.